Good evening and welcome to this Thursday, November 7, 2019 edition of News Update. I'm Sandy Ramutar. For the top stories we're tracking this evening. Dissolve Parliament on December 2 face more protests, Jagdeo warns Granger. Jagdeo remains confident ID card will not be a requirement for eligible Guyanese to vote. 13 held as police close in on suspected carjacking ring. Lack of protection for fishermen at sea continues to be a sore issue in the industry. And in sport, Windies women collapse the 6-wicket defeat to India. These and more coming up after the break. Stay with us.
Mark?
I'm in the kitchen.
This is amazing! I love your tiles.
Make an impression with the finest tiles imported by Lens. Lens has a huge selection of various tiles for your wall, floor, and pool needs. All of our tiles are of grade A quality, which are the highest quality tile rated. That means they last longer and are less likely to damage or crack. We're the sole distributor for many reputable companies around the world. At Lens, we have special deals for contractors and bulk shoppers. Shop at any of our locations to get the best in tiles. Lens, our product, your creation.
Did you know almost one-third of deaths in Guyana are heart-related? Chronic inflammation is the root cause of atherosclerosis, the process that leads to cholesterol-clogged arteries. You can now lower high triglyceride levels with Omega XL and reduce the dangerous inflammation that causes these problems. So to ensure a healthy heart and reduce your risk of disease, get your Omega XL today. Live long, stay strong with Omega XL.
Everything is connected, our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Puran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
You know, since me find out about Tire Future Shop, me house look nicer than you one. Hey, hey, credit rate. How you can afford to buy all them things?
I'm going to tell you.
Now me not going to catch again our secret.
No, come on, man. A magic. You're too fast. Mind the business.
Excuse me, uncle. Tell me something. How credit can afford to buy so much thing from I? Only now walk no way.
It's because now we introduce our new discount card.
Apply now for your discount card at Tayo Future Shop. Every time you shop using your discount card, your percentage increases. Start from 5% off. Your next purchase, 7% off. Then 10% off, etc. Until you start getting wholesale and factory price. Check in store for more details. Conditions apply.
Help me get me Tayo discount card. Wait, man. What you gotta do next, man? Buy the whole entire store?
Curtains and Drapery is proud to introduce their new line of Venetian blinds to Guyana. So if you're looking to upgrade your home, office, or conference room with a sleek modern look, then Venetian blinds are sure to do the trick. You'll be amazed at how a simple installation of these blinds can transform any space. Venetian blinds offer optimal light control versus traditional blinds and are customizable and low maintenance. Call us today for a free estimate and let's upgrade those blinds. Also, we've expanded our range of services to include dry cleaning of drapes and carpets. Curtains and Drapery, 110 Regent Street. Our telephone numbers are 225-2224 and 226-2019.
Welcome back now for the news in detail. The People's Progressive Party is threatening to protest Mr. Granger in the absence of the dissolution of Parliament by December 2, 2019. Opposition leader Bharat Jagdeo today threatened to resume protests if caretaker President David Granger does not dissolve the parliament. Jagdeo demanded for the parliament to be dissolved by December 2, 2019, in keeping with the constitutional 3 months before the holding of general elections. Mr. Granger has proclaimed March 2, 2020 as the date for the holding of regional and national elections.
He has to dissolve parliament. He has to issue a proclamation. Let him delay that and we resume the protests, because that's part of the holding of elections or the dissolution of parliament. And so I'm making it clear to him, if he thinks he's going to hang on there.
Mr. Granger told media operatives yesterday that he has no immediate plans to dissolve parliament because the House will have to approve additional spending in the absence of the 2020 budget. But Jagdeo reminded that the caretaker administration can access funds for emergencies from the contingency fund. He pointed the caretaker president to the recent move by his administration to withdraw over $800 million from the contingency fund after the flooding in Mykone and West Demerara just about 2 weeks ago. Then there is a provision where, in the absence of a national budget for a fiscal year, 1/12 of the previous year budget could be used to ensure government services are provided. Opposition leader Bharat Jagdeo is certain that registrants will be allowed to vote in spite of the absence of the national identification card. Opposition leader Bharat Jagdeo is optimistic that all registrants will be permitted to vote even in the absence of uncollected identification cards. He believes the Elections Commission will resolve the issue to allow for persons to exercise their constitutional right to vote on Elections Day.
What do I have to say on this issue? This matter was debated. There's been no formal position, but I gather that there is a compromise that will ensure enhanced verification, but not remove people's names from the voters' list or remove their right to vote.
The Elections Commission intends to move ahead with its decision to remove the names of persons from the National Register of Registrants dating back to 2008. The decision will see some 28,000 persons being removed from the voters' list. The name of persons who failed to uplift their national identification cards dating back to 2008 will be published in the newspapers. The names will be published this weekend. In addition to this, notices will be sent to their addresses, giving them 21 days within which to collect their identification cards. People's Progressive Party presidential candidate Air Finale today dismantled the view of a small portion of people that the party's leader Bharat Jagdeo will be his puppet master when he advances the presidency.
There have been some talks that the PPP's presidential candidate Air Finale will play to the tune of Jagdeo's fiddle should he become president. However, Ali, during a newsroom interview, said his party leader is not a control freak. Rather, he is merely results driven. Further, he noted he will not be stringed as a puppet by anyone, the least being Jagdeo. Ali, in his quest to dismantle the view, praised the work of Jagdeo while expressing gratitude for the support and the vision of him.
The support of Bharat Jagdeo, the benefit of having him on your team, the benefit of having his experience cannot be understated. It's enormous for any political party. I'm convinced that AP and UAFC would love to have a Bharat Jagdeo or a similar figure on their side. Unfortunately, they don't have that asset.
But Ali must first overcome APNU's David Granger in the 2020 elections before he can become president. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
Opposition leader Bharat Jagdeo wants an international consultant to verify the data garnered from the truncated house-to-house registration. Opposition leader Bharat Jagdeo has again opposed the merging of the data garnered from the suspended house-to-house registration with the preliminary list of electors. He said there has been constant inaccuracies and errors recorded on the list that has been put up for public scrutiny. Jagdeo claimed there are dual registrations and inaccurate addresses recorded on the list.
So we are finding now, we have had a chance to look through some of the house-to-house data, and I have several examples here that I can share with you later of double registration. We just had a preliminary look at it. Double registration. We have wrong divisions being named. We have a number of other errors like wrong addresses, spelling errors in the name, whole range of stuff like that.
The commission has registered 370,822 persons from July 20 to August 31, 2019. The commission is still to state its position on how it intends to merge the registration data to form the preliminary list of electors. Still ahead, 13 Health is police close in on suspected carjacking ring. Lack for protection for fishermen at sea continues to be a sore issue in the industry. And in sport, Windies women collapse the 6-wicket defeat to India. These and more when we return. Stay with us.
Bushy Park Beach Barica presents a day of sports and beach party on Sunday the 10th of November at Bushy Park Beach Resort. Come and enjoy sports activities including 100 meter races, the tug of war, lime and spoon, sack race for boys, girls, males and female, and a whole lot more with music by Heatwave Sound System and DJ Casey passing through. A well-stocked bar is going to be in attendance on Sunday the 10th of November at Bushy Park Beach Resort. Compliments of Stag and Man's Beer.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look at 5 and 10, glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes aglow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas, toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will
jithe vi tu chalna hai mahi va tere piche piche chalna tu jee sakdi nahi main jee sakda nahi koi dusri main shartaan vi rakhda nahi kya tere
It happens. Your septic tank is full. All the waste from your toilet goes into your septic tank through the sewage line. When your tank is full, the two most common indicators are an overflowing tank and an overflowing toilet. It is recommended that Sevon's Waste Management empty your septic tank every 2 to 3 years to avoid any embarrassment. And before you can say, shh, it's gone. Call Sevon's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
Now using Softex toilet tissue. Available in leading supermarkets countrywide, Softex is always silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp and babies love it. Softex comes available in single rolls, economy pack, six pack, and one dozen packages. Just perfect for any budget. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, telephone 622-4197.
Welcome back. You're still watching MTV's News Update. The police have arrested 13 persons in connection to a suspected carjacking ring, which operated at various locations within the Kuru-Kuru-Suzdai Glenin Highway.
Ranks of the Ghana Police Force acting on intelligence snooped down at several locations along the village of Kurukururu and discovered a number of vehicle parts, including shells of pit bull minibuses, 192 motor cars, 150 elite motorcycle, 5 generators, 3 motor cars and 2 weeding machines. The exercise was conducted yesterday and articles found are suspected to either have been stolen or unlawfully obtained. The articles were all found at different locations within the Kurukururu district. Since then, individuals have come forward and identified some of the articles as theirs. The police have already arrested 13 persons as investigation into the matter continues. In February of this year, the police carried out a 10-hour operation at the Kurukuru location and seized two cars and a canter truck registered to a Bar Street Kitty resident. Discovered inside the vehicles were the shells of a silver Toyota Spazio and a quantity of vehicle parts. An ex-policeman, his wife, and several other women were arrested and subsequently charged with the discovery. The ex-policeman was said to have been the mastermind behind the ring. Along with the village of Monument Hill, Kurukuru, Suzdike, Linden Highway, raids were also carried out in North Vrijslust, East Coast, Demerara. Police believe that the vehicles were stolen during carjackings and stripped of their parts, which are being sold. Reporting from MTV News Update, Lashona Gomes, Cornelius.
Region 6 Vice Chairman Dennis Thirup is disheartened by the lack of safety measures for fishermen in the face of the recent deadly pirate attack.
Via a telephone interview, Thirup explained that more is needed to effectively deal with piracy. Thirup argues features like more high-frequency radio systems for boats are needed for fishermen and coast guards. An active patrol system must also be in place. Radio systems, he noted, are also absent in most fishing vessels working in the Guyana-Suriname waters.
So the police need to be more proactive with these things, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You can't wait until you get a piracy attack. You need to operate in a better way. They had initiated a patrol system where the Coast Guard will patrol and they have radio contact with the boats and so on, or with the base here. So in just as you have a reported case, you can respond quickly, not 2-3 days after.
Mm.
But that system is not working. They had that some time back, but they don't have the patrol system no more.
Thirup highlighted the need for a collaborative effort between the police forces and coast guards of both Guyana and Suriname to ensure that the waterways are actively monitored.
The challenging thing is that the quarantine riverway, the Dutch is claiming, Suriname is claiming, so it's hard for them to patrol in the quarantine riverside too. So they need to work out some system with the Surinamese government that both Suriname Coast Guard as well as Guyana Coast Guard can patrol the radio system, and you have it from the base to the boat. The police and army all need to be linked, know what is going on.
On October 5, 2019, four fishermen from the quarantine Werbis area who boarded a fishing vessel out to sea were ruthlessly beaten, bound, and butchered before being thrown into the sea by a group of pirates. Since then, three of the suspects have been charged, while two others who were apprehended in Suriname are to be charged later this week. Reporting for MTV News Update, Lashona Gomes, Cornelius.
Meanwhile, on a visit to the Meadowbank fishing wharf early today, several fishermen raised their concerns over the lack of patrol in the waterways.
Right, when you call them, they have nothing to do, they have nothing to send. Eh? Only a helicopter can solve this problem. Watch if you get some rage up on them boat, they say. If me this boat, they tell a whiny, you can talk to them. Right, when you talk, nobody ain't coming. So we know what they're doing. Nobody ain't coming at all. No, man, this thing happened long. This thing happened long with fishermen that get killed and get robbed. This not happen for now. This has happened long and nobody not do nothing to this. Yeah, nothing they not do.
No, they're not too safe, you know.
Why do you
remember
say that?
The storm and the, you know, the breeze and so, and the wave, how it's so big and so. Yeah, out there's rough and so, man.
Well, really and truly, I said the Guyana police forces, like, they gotta do their best, because for we fishermen, we never really like get the real security out there for us, because we just go there for looking for daily bread. And whenever done for us, it's like, you know, something like busy, we scared of it. Yeah, because when you're out there, you're working for honest doll, and when people come and taking your things, they're like, you know, they're not really nice.
Being a newcomer in the world of politics, the Liberty and Justice Party today admitted that it has not the answers for the issues facing Guyana. If elected into government, the party intends to consult all other parties for ideas and plans to develop Guyana.
New into the political arena, leader and presidential candidate of the Liberty and the Justice Party, Lennox Schumann, admitted today to media operatives that his party cannot solve all the issues hampering the country's development and will be dependent on the vision of other political players.
And I'd humbly submit that the Liberty and Justice Party also does not have all of the answers. But what we are open to doing is to working with all political parties and all Guyanese to finding the solutions to addressing all of the issues that affect Guyana.
The LJP leader said it will not act as the other parties did that campaigned on false promises. One such promise is that of constitutional reform, a promise made by the APNU-AFC in the lead-up to the 2015 general and the regional elections. To date, there has been no reformation to the constitution. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
Region 5 Chairman Vic Chenramphal is criticizing the lagging approach of the Regional Democratic Council in dealing with pressing matters which affects residents in the region. One such matter, Ramphal said, is that of the recent sea defense breach at Danzig, which is located near areas of farmland.
Chairman for Region 5, Vikchand Ramphal, is dissatisfied that the Regional Democratic Council statutory meeting is not regularly being held to effectively thrash out and find meaningful ways to deal with the many issues facing rice and cash crop farmers in the region. The regional chairman is of the firm belief APNU AFC councillors and other figures in the RDC are not taking certain matters seriously, such as those relating to flooding in the region.
Secondly, because of the RDC cannot have a successful statutory meeting, that also bothers me a lot because we cannot sit as a region, as a council, and make proper decision for the people of this region and to address the many issues that are affecting them, like the current one.
Ramphal argues if the council and even those in the government had taken his heed earlier in the year regarding the state of some dams and potential breaches that could occur, the region would be in a far better position than it is right now. Ramphal also complained of the state of the farm-to-market road as both rainfall and the recent sea defense breach at Danzig has made transporting their goods and produce quite daunting. This, he noted, is also a major concern which the RDC ought to effectively address and manage.
Had the government then, when I highlighted this, they had taken action, that could have been prevented. Of course, there are many other issues. Right now, the farm-to-market roads are in a deplorable state. Very little work has been done. And farmers now, they're incurring additional expenses because of the current condition.
As regarding needs of the farmers in the region after the recent sea defense breach, Ramphal noted no assistance has since been granted to them. Reporting for MTV News Update, LaShawna Gomes, Cornelius.
Here is Celine Griffith with MTV's Court Roundup.
A farmer was today hauled before Chief Magistrate Anne McLennan to answer to an attempted murder charge. 56-year-old Ronald John, called Queen Boy John of 5 Miles Cobano Road, Morocco, Northwest District, was not required to plead to the indictable charge which read that on November 2 at 5 Miles Kumaka Cobano Road, Northwest District, with intent to commit murder, he unlawfully wounded Anthony Atkinson. According to reports, on the day in question, the virtual complainant was passing the defendant's home when he saw an individual with whom he had a previous misunderstanding. The virtual complainant allegedly stopped and spoke with the person, after which the accused intervened and dealt the victim several lashes about the body, after which he took a hammer and hit the man twice to the head, causing injuries including lacerations to the left and right scalp, as well as a fracture to the right frontal bone of the skull. In his defense, however, John, whose right hand was bandaged, told the magistrate that the virtual complainant is known for being violent, and he was acting in self-defense after the man attacked him with a cutlass, resulting in a chop to his hand. He went on to say that no hammer was used during the incident, but instead a wood from his orange tree. Police prosecutor Gordon Mansfield made no objections, but requested that bail be set to a substantial amount and that conditions be attached. As such, bail was granted in the sum of $100,000. Conditions of the bail restrict John from coming within 50 feet of the virtual complainant. Ronald John is expected to make his next court appearance at the Aquero Magistrates Court on January 7, 2020. In another matter, a teen who allegedly carried out a number of robberies in the Jorsheng area and is no stranger to the courts was today sentenced to 1 year imprisonment when he appeared before Magistrate Anit Singh at the Jorsheng Magistrates Court. Chris Pollard, 19, of Durban Street Lodge, had denied the charge, which alleged that on September 13, 2019, at Camp Street, while being in the company of others, he robbed Sachin Narayan of a cell phone valued $45,000. According to reports, on the day in question, the victim was walking along Camp Street while on his cell phone when Pollard, who was in the company of others, snatched his cell phone. Police on patrol were alerted and gave chase, thereby arresting Pollard. He was searched and the phone was recovered in his possession. In August of this year, Pollard was released on $20,000 bail by Chief Magistrate Anne McLennan for stealing a woman's $45,000 cell phone while she was sitting in a Route 40 minibus along Crow Street, Georgetown. In March, Pollard was slapped with five robbery charges after he allegedly went on a phone-snatching spree along Crow Street, Georgetown. And in January, Pollard was charged before a city magistrate for a similar offense and was released on $40,000 bail. Finally, a man was today committed to stand trial for the 2018 murder of a Guyana Water Incorporated employee. 21-year-old Matthew Parks, formerly of East Lepenitent's Jorsheng, was committed by Magistrate Faith McGusty, who ruled that a sufficient case was made out against Park for him to stand trial at the next practical sitting of the Demerara Assizes. The indictment alleged that Parks, on September 13, 2018, at Durban and Chapel Street's Lodge, murdered 23-year-old Roger Allen. According to the police, on the day in question, Allen visited the mini-mart where Parks worked, and they had an altercation over some cigarettes. It was further reported that later in the afternoon, when the defendant exited his workplace, he was confronted by Allen, who was reportedly armed with a piece of wood and a knife. A scuffle ensued and both men received injuries. They were both escorted to the Jorsheng Public Hospital Corporation, where Allen underwent emergency surgery for two suspected stab wounds, but later succumbed to his injuries. Reporting for MTV's Court Roundup, Celine Griffith.
We now join Rajesh Lakhan for What Do People Say.
What are your thoughts on the current crime situation? Let's say what the people had to say.
I think it should get a better balance in the different types of classes in lifestyle. And people will be able to reason with each other and live together in harmony. Because some persons don't have jobs and these things, and it pushes them to do certain things.
Well, I think they should come out regular and see what's going on, because the crime rate is too much.
From the looks of things, the police are a little too laid-back in some instances. I'm talking about your local community police who might be operating in the outpost or the station in your community. You might get familiar with the people them that is frequent the station, and that becomes a sticky situation. You understand? So on the level, I could tell you they could do something more about that. If they got to switch up the stations more often, if they got to do something about it, so they could be effective in the community.
What do you think are the contributing factors to the current crime situation?
Jobs, one. Two, education. I mean, city council could take on more people. We're in front of CTR right now. They could take on more people. We need more people for cleaning the drains. They don't deseal the drains. They're just taking up from the edges and these kind of things. So a city council could employ more people. They could put more money in the budget for higher employment rate at city council and find more jobs in some way. Encourage the people to take up the jobs. You know what I mean?
Yes, I'm concerned because where I'm living, I wouldn't say where, but, you know, you can walk as you like. I mean, I'm not a party fan now. I don't go out. But if you do go out, taxis don't want to go there to take you home. So it's really not safe. It's really not safe on the streets now. You know, the police, the Guyana police force, they need to do something more.
Well, there is they need to find solution to these criminal activities and organized criminal activities going on. And with that, I think they should institute longer penalties, because once the longer penalties are being instituted, the younger ones would take precautions, and they would find a meaningful way of earning an income, also creating job opportunities and honoring their obligations, as was said and promised, has yet not been delivered. Also, general rehabilitation is an immediate need, I think, and that would help to fight the situation, leaving out the loopholes and confidentiality with these things too, and especially what has been going on with a lack of credibility with intelligence officers and police officers, especially when it comes to protecting us. They also has been going haywire with the crime situation as well.
Well, what I have to say is that, well, I'm studying criminology right now at university, and what I think they should do, right, is they should get more police patrolling the roads at night, because we be coming out to campus, beside the fact there are guards there, we still just get robbed. Anyways, so I think there should be police at the head all over, nighttime especially, because I can't even go outside and start sitting on my back step because I'm scared of people running in the house or so forth. So I think there should be more police traversing the areas more often.
They need to step up. They need to do their job, because the crime is out of control. And if you ask people around, they will say because there's not amount of jobs. So if people looking for money, and they're going to get it in any ways necessary. And if you look at the crimes, it's a lot of young people. And if you look at the background, these are people who have family to maintain. So they're not going to, because they're not going to work for something that they find or feel that is not sufficient for them. So they will say, look, I can't work at this store as a chauffeur or something. So the fastest way for me to get money is by stepping out and doing the crime. So the Guyana Defense Force need to step up and be more force in what they're doing.
For MTV News Update, I'm Rajesh Lakhan.
Coming up after the break, MTV's sports update and more. Stay with us.
Enter the GBTI Quick Cash Christmas promotion and make it a Christmas to remember. You get up to $500,000 easy for anything you want this Christmas. Plus, enter for a chance to win fabulous items for your home. One complete 7-foot granite top base kitchen cabinet, one sectional suite, one 5-piece dinette set, and complimentary baskets of goodies. Apply at your nearest branch or online at www.gbtibank.com. GBTI. We see Christmas through your eyes.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any 5 numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
Thank you.
Get the right seal right now from Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., your immediate SKF sealing solutions. The SKF seal jet machine is capable of building seals from 5mm to 600mm in diameter in under 5 minutes. With technical support readily available, you can get a customized seal to suit virtually any industrial application, like buffer, rod, wiper, and piston seals. SKF seal jet machine, now at Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc.
The brilliancy of Captain Stephanie Taylor and Kishona was not enough to save West Indies from a 2-1 series defeat by India. India handed West Indies a 6-wicket defeat in a final ODI yesterday.
The Indian women clinched the series by 6 wickets. The West Indies women won the toss and elected to bat first, but the opening batters found it difficult to get the scoring started. No runs were scored in the first 2 overs. Later came the partnership that took the West Indies women innings to a defendable total. Stacey Ann King and Stephanie Taylor took the singles and twos. Stephanie collected a return shot using her gloves to protect her from a straight drive from Stacey Ann. This pair added 96 runs before Stephanie was caught and bowled by Poonam Yadav for a brilliant 79. The rest of the West Indies women's batters fell for single digits as they finished their 50 overs on 194 all out. India started their run chase confidently with Smriti Mandhana playing for the first time in the series. Together with Jemima Rodrigues, who has struggled with the bat this series, the pair took a liking to the West Indies bowlers. India had a slight wobble with 4 wickets falling in a short pace of overs, but they were comfortable winners by 6 wickets in 42.1 overs, finishing on 195 for 6. The tour now shifts focus to 5 T20 internationals, with the first 2 being played in St. Lucia on November 9 and 10, then in Guyana on November 14, 17 and 20. Chelsea Lee, reporting for MTV Sports Update.
We tell you now that Yorkshire have resigned West Indies wicketkeeper and batsman Nicholas Pooran for the majority of next year's T20 Blast group stage. Pooran, 24, had a spell with the Vikings last season, hitting 67 off 28 balls in the win over Leicester. Yorkshire's coach Andrew Gall said Pooran is a great signing for the team. He said Pooran's display in the last season is evidence he is a superstar of T20 cricket. Pooran, who played for his country in this year's World Cup, has scored 2,302 runs in 120 T20 matches with a strike rate of 143.78. Excitement is already in the air for the biggest event at the Lusignan Golf Club called the Grand Golf Classic. Competition is expected to be tight when the event teases off on Saturday.
In their efforts to ensure there is a large field of players, this weekend's tournament will tee off from 11 hours. Trophies and prizes for 3 categories of play and specialty awards for the longest drive and the nearest to the pin are up for grabs. This will be the 3rd event for Anson McCall at the LGC, having hosted the Suzuki Motors Invitational and co-hosting the Lusignan Open. This event will be the grand finale for Anson McCall, and the players and the public are urged to come out as the company will offer great deals and samples on Dewar's and other branded products. The Grand Golf Classic tees off from 11 hours at the Lusignan Golf Club on Saturday. Chelsea Lee, reporting for MTV Sports Update.
A 43-ball 85 from Rohit Sharma in his 100 T20 International helped India chase down 154 with 26 balls to spare and draw level in the T20 International Series against Bangladesh. It was Rohit's 3rd quickest innings of 50 or more in T20 Internationals, and it made a below-par Bangladesh total at the presentation. Their captain, Mahmud Hala, reckoned their finish 25 for 30 runs, short of par look utterly inadequate in flat batting conditions in Rajkot. India have been a bit of a Jekyll and Hyde T20 international team of late. Since the start of 2018, they have a 7-7 record while batting first, but they've done much better while chasing. Thursday's win was their 13th in 16 completed games. Rohit came into their series having just scored 3 hundreds, including a double, in 3 tests against South Africa, and all that form was at display today at the Rajkot pitch, brimming with runs. Every shot he played along the ground seemed to be a fine gap, whether he was pulling or driving or cutting or even occasionally when he was simply defending with a slightly open face. The one such shot of Al Amin Hussein in the 5th over of Indian innings raced away unstoppably between backward point and short third man. The results were even more spectacular when he went aerial. There were 6 sixes in his innings. Everyone else on both sides only managed 2 between them, including 3 in a row of Mozakirik Hussain's off-spin in the 10th over. The second of them, which brought up the century opening stand which Shikharda won, took Rohit to 70. The one at that point was batting on 28 off 24 balls. Bangladesh managed to keep one opener quiet by defying him with, but none of their plans had any impact on the other. Saints Hockey Club and GBTI Spartans registered the first victories of the 6th annual Junior Indoor Hockey Tournament last evening in the Farfan and Mendon's Under 16 League.
The GBTI Spartans trashed YMCA Old Fort 10-0 during the first match of the girls' division. Abu Said Cadogan secured 4 goals and was supported by Madison Fernandes and Haley Carpenter with 3 each. Meanwhile, over in match 2, SHC Supreme beat SHC Sensations 2-1. Charlia Webb and Mariah Sigobin posted 1 goal each to lead their team to victory over Danery Magoo's lone goal. The boys' division of the Farfan and Mendes Under 16 League saw SHC Silencers humble the GCC War Dogs 3-1. Baraka Garnett netted 2 penalty goals assisted by Jonathan Bisoon, while Nakuma Hudson secured the lone goal for the War Dogs. The Junior Indoor Hockey Tournament continues until Sunday with matches in the Under 10 and Under 21 divisions at the Cliff Anderson Sports Hall. Chelsea Lee, reporting for MTV's Sports Update.
Diamond League meetings will no longer feature the 200 meters and 3000 meters steeplechase, discus or triple jump at all of its events in 2020. Athletics governing body, the IAAF, said it did research on the popularity of events and wished to cut the length of meetings for a 90-minute broadcast. There will be 12 disciplines staged at each of the 15 Diamond League meetings. The 3000 meters steeplechase and 200 meter will feature at 10 meetings, while 2 will stage discus and triple jump. None of the 4 disciplines removed from the core list will form part of the Diamond League final in Zurich in September. The IAAF said its decision followed research on the popularity of events, which were conducted in China, France, South Africa and the USA, while surveys were carried out in Belgium, Great Britain and Switzerland. Discus triple jump and the 3000 meter steeplechase ranked lowest in terms of popularity, while the 200 meters was taken off the core list as organizers felt its inclusion alongside the 100 meters meant the schedule would be too congested, particularly in an Olympic Games year. Former World 400 Hurdles champion Day Green tweeted, "There's no such thing as a boring event. It's how you present it to the public. That's the problem." 45 local tennis players will for the next 5 weeks undergo high-performance training to be conducted by a Level 1 Cuban coach. This will serve as a basis for the Table Tennis Association to identify uprising talent.
The program's target group ranges between the ages of 12 to 16 years old and recently recruited ITTF Level 1 Cuban coach Osdani Garcia, who is on a 2-month stint in Guyana, will be working with the players for a 5-week period. The program aims to provide high-quality training and services for young, talented athletes. The players were selected based on their performance in domestic competitions, technical and tactical skills, aptitude, discipline and raw talent. The GTTA seeks to provide a platform for the players with potential to benefit from high-level training. Chelsea Lee, reporting for MTV's Sports Update.
More news after the break. Stay with us.
Get the right seal right now from Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., your immediate SKF sealing solutions. The SKF seal jet machine is capable of building seals from 5mm to 600mm in diameter in under 5 minutes. With technical support readily available, you can get a customized seal to suit virtually any industrial application, like buffer, rod, wiper, and piston seals. SKF seal jet machine, now at Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc.
Welcome back, you're still with MTV's News Update. Now for some news in the region. The mayor of a small town in Bolivia has been attacked by opposition protesters who dragged her through the streets barefoot, covered her in red paint and forcibly cut her hair. Patricia Arc of the governing mass party was handed over to police in Vendo after several hours. It is the latest in a series of violent clashes between government supporters and opponents in the wake of controversial presidential elections. At least 3 people have died so far. A group of anti-government protesters was blocking a bridge in Vendo, a small town in Cochabamba province in central Bolivia, as part of the ongoing demonstrations following the presidential election on October 20. Rumors spread that 2 opposition protesters had been killed nearby in clashes with supporters of incumbent President Evo Morales, prompting an angry group to march to the town hall. On the international scene, President Emmanuel Macron of France has described NATO as brain dead, stressing what he sees as wanting commitment to the transatlantic alliance by its main guarantor, the US. Interviewed by The Economist, he cited the US failure to consult NATO before pulling forces out of northern Syria. He also questioned whether NATO was still committed to collective defense. German Chancellor Angela Merkel, a key ally, said she disagreed with Mr. Macron's drastic words. Russia, which sees NATO as a threat to its security, welcomed the French president's comments as truthful words. NATO, which celebrates 70 years since its founding at the London summit next month, has responded by saying the alliance remains strong. And that has brought us to the end of regional and international news. Now let's take a look at the Ghana Stock Exchange closing prices for trading session 8:50. Let's now turn our attention to the Demer Harbour Bridge and the Barbados River Bridge schedules. This is where we wrap up this evening's broadcast, but before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. Dissolved Parliament and December 2 are faced more protests, Jagdeo warns Granger. Jagdeo remains confident ID cards will not be a requirement for eligible Guyanese to vote. 13th held is police closing on suspected carjacking ring. Lack of protection for fishermen at sea continues to be a sore issue in the industry. And in sport, Windies women collapsed a 6-wicket defeat to India. Cars are rebirth cars at 23 hours today and at 6 hours 30 tomorrow. On behalf of our news and technical teams, I'm Sandy Ramutar. Have a good night.